Hello everyone, welcome. So this is a new tutorial, and in this tutorial we're going to start some mini series, and this series will be the name of making a kitchen scene. So inside this series we will make two models. This model is inspired by Blender Guru, and as you can see he has made a latest version of this cub, and this is in Blender 2.8, which is for beginners. And we will make the same from this tutorial, and we will make another cub, which is this hot cub, and we will make an cold original cube cub, and let's see how we can make it inside Blender 2.8. So if you have searched online, you will see that a lot of types of cub, and as you can see all these are coffee cub, and you can start from any cub you may find that is suitable for you. Basically I will start from this one which is here. So let's go to the main. So here we are inside the main interface. Basically you can hide this tool shelf by clicking on the T, and I will start as usual by enable the screencast keys. Maybe you can hide the timeline which will be here. So this is the basic scene I will start from, and I will go and go to the front view, and let's go to add a reference. This reference will be an image reference, and I will open this image. So if you want to make an edit for this image or this reference, you can go here and make it depth to front and the side to both or right, and display in the perspective. If you want to do a two and hide in the perspective, you can go here and hide in the perspective. And for the scale, as usual it's 5. Maybe let's go here, and let's start by rename this to be design, and after that I will start by making a circle. This circle, but make sure that your model in the center, it can be offset to 0 and 0. Alright, I will start from here and make the cursor at this point and add a circle. This circle will be 32 as usual, and let's scale down. So I will make this cub using non-real dimensions, and after that finally we will scale it. So go to the wireframe, and maybe I want to choose the image and make the transparency lower, such as this. Alright, so I will select the circle and the scale down, and go here, and after that I will extrude in the z-axis and scale down to this limit. Right, after that we can extrude and scale to this distance, extrude and scale, extrude and scale, scale. Let's select this one and scale shift Z. Let's extrude another time and scale shift Z. So let's extrude another time like this and scale shift Z. Then we have some loop cuts here. Anyway, we now are done, but let's close this one to extrude scale shift Z.9 and fill the face. Alright, so we can go here and move or rotate. So I will make the cursor to selected and rotate around the cursor, and then inside the right view I will rotate by 7 point, rotate in Z 7.5. maybe we must calculate it better, so rotate in Z 7.5. So I will pause the video until I calculate the angle to rotate it to be symmetrized on the y-axis. So if we have calculated the angle, we have around 32. We have exactly 32 division. So we have complete circle of two. Let's go here. So we have an where is the text editor, and we can start new. So we have this degrees complete circle divided by 32. Then we want to calculate this to be around 11, and after that we will see that we have a complete, we have to rotate it directly. Anyway, let's move to the next step. After that, I will select this face by going to select this face, and in this view, I will extrude to this distance. Then we can move it like this, and we can move it like this, and we can move it to be so I will select this face and right click, maybe right extrude and move here, and let's select this vertex and move to this place. Finally, we will select these two faces and right click to bridge these edge loops. We have also the loop tools to bridge, which is here. Let's go and add some loop cuts, and after that we must be in the wireframe to select all these vertex and move to an to move by G here, and add another loop cut and move here. Anyway, let's add some loop cuts here and add another loop cut here. If you want to be defined, you can make the pivot point to be a median point and scale these areas to match the proportions, and you can scale all these. After that, we will make some cool tips and tricks. We will select one of these edges, and basically this edge, we can add this for now. Basically this edge is much smaller or less wider than the other area, so we will go to this proportional editing and enable, make it smooth, and scale on Y and lower the circle such as this and make it smaller like this, and select this one and make it smaller like this, and we are now done, I think. Let's go to select this one and extrude scale shift Z sometimes in this, and scale shift disable the proportional editing, and you can now extrude or scale down like this, you can also add the solidify modifier, but I think it's more accurate result than using the solidify modifier. Alright, and now I think we are done for this. We can add some loop cut here and let's UV unwrap this. So I will select all these faces. All these edges, and let's select by left click and the Alt Shift to add these loops, and let's add this one and maybe Control E to mark seam. Select any of these areas and Control E to mark seam. Let's go and make an inset for this one. Clear this seam and define this to be an seam. So I will select all and U to be unwrapping this one and come to the UV editing, and as you can see it's now done, but we have these stretching areas. So I have downloaded an add-on which is called UV squares, and this add-on will do a lot of job and a lot of work for us, and this add-on will be helpful. So you can search for UV squares only and enable this add-on. After that you can select using this one, you can select this and come to the in UV squares and to grid by shape. So you must select snap to grid. I think that this add-on doesn't work because I have the screen cascade working and there is a conflict between the shortcuts. But to be honest, it's easy to select this area and to grid by shape. But if you have doesn't have the add-on, you will select row by row like this, and scale on X you must select like this, and scale on X 0 and so on. We can do it manually, but the add-on can save a lot of time. So I will pause the video until I scale all these rows and columns. And now we have added the subdivision surface and the level of 3, maybe 2 in the viewport, and make shading to be as smooth. Make sure that the shading to be as smooth, and if you want to make more thickness, you can select the inner and scale down so it may be better. Let's go and make our cup filled by water. So it's easy to select the inner part, and let's go from here, Control plus to this one, and after that you must be, let's select again this face, and after that duplicate and sever it by selection. Let's see what we have here. Then we can select this one and extrude scale shift Z, extrude scale shift Z, and it will be such as this. And maybe scaling some points, because in real life there isn't a space like this. Anyway, maybe we scale down the inner area. And let's go to add the materials. The materials is so easy. So for this one we have an principal glass. Glass is basically a principal shader, and we can go to the shader editor to make it better. To define it, and transmission will be 1 and roughness will be 0. So that is the glass. And you can define the color as you want. For this one it will be an also principled and it will be maybe T. And let's go also for the shader editor, and the basic transmission will be also 1, and roughness will be 0, and IOR will be 1.333. For the volume, we have an volume, of course. So let's make the volume volume absorption, and after that we will make the density around 500, and the color will be like this. And after that, let's go to the 3D viewport. Maybe I want to parent the water to the cup. And let's see what we have. So I think if we add this cup will be around 10 centimeter long. So we can add a plane. This plane will be dimensions of 0.1 by 0.1 by 0.1, and we can scale it down like this. But let's select the plane and rotate, and we will use this to scale down, move to match our proportions, and let's scale like this. So this is a real dimension. I will make the cursor at the center by making Shift C and select this one, and cursor not cursor to selected. Let's make Shift C and the selection to cursor. Now we are done for this one. So let's add the wooden plate. I will make a plane. This plane will be a wood plate. So we will add another wooden material. Color will be some image texture. This image will be an wooden. So you can choose an image texture which is seamless one. So I will open. So I have added the plane and to be defined. And I have added an texture for the floor. And I have added this main light and this fill light. As you can see, we have some problem for the face orientation. So I will select this one, I shift in to flip these normals. And for also the water, we can select all and shift in to flip all these. And after that, we can add an environmental texture. This can be any HDR eye lighting. This is what you will get if you have added an HDR eye lighting, and you can choose it as you like. If you struggle with the lighting, you can rotate the HDR eye from shader editor and from world. You can select this one and control T and move it as you want in the Z axis. And you can choose the strength as you like. And this is our result if we have rotated the environmental texture. I will stop in this video for this item. And in the next video, we will make another different cup model, and we add some water, and we will add both in up to this floor and render both. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. See you in the next tutorial.